When I listened to yesterday's videos last night, I saw that I probably spoke as fast as I ever have in these videos and jumped around subject probably more than ever. Crazy. I know that was between the two of them, it was 45 minutes packed with information, and my mind just swarms when I do these videos, when I see all the parallels he's doing, his almighty works and everything. And you know, it's just what it is, but it's amazing. I really didn't hear any error, except one time I think I said 328 instead of, I should have said 728 or vice versa or something. But truly amazing how all the details he's woven into this. And it's not like in the old days where I had a computer before it was stolen from our maker and I could sit in the shed or the spitty in Greece look at the computer screen and put the verses up on the screen and talk about them and such. I'm fled to the wilderness, so even though I have a little some notes here to details in some videos I don't have the same resources on account of you stealing from our maker. But even so, you didn't listen, you didn't come out from Egypt. But it's amazing. I speak of the spitty in Greece. It's a Greek word for house, but that in Theopetra of all things. And just today's assembly reading in Isaiah 16 first verse is talking about, I'm going to send you from Petra the rock go to the wilderness. Led to the wilderness with the daughters of Zion and everything. It's just amazing. His whole book's written upon the here and the now. And the reality is, the testimony of his word is the light. It is the light that we walk in. Yeshua said, I am the light of the world. Well, he came in the image of his father's word. How much more so that his second son of his Zechariah 4:14, holy anointing oil, who his entire word's written upon. There are only partial scriptures written upon his first son, his only begotten son, Yeshua, only partial. It's just what it is. But behold, like Psalms 40 verse 7 says, behold, I come in the roll of the book that's written upon me. The entire book, of course, minus the writings of the abomination of desolation, Saul of Tarsus and his rat pack, Luke and Mark. But it's just what it is, folks. I'm the light of the world. Yahweh's word, the testimony of his word is the light. But you'd love darkness rather than the light. It's just what it is. You don't want to walk in the light. Matter of fact, in his Meher Shalal Kushbaz prophecy in Isaiah chapter 9, I guess verse 2, he's talking about you, the people that walk in the darkness, the walkers of the darkness. And behold, they've seen a great light. And it's amazing, the manner he's sending forth this Emmanuel Manchild, Meher Shalal Kushbaz, and this Manchild's three siblings. I mean, I'm going to give you some parallels if I can remember to here in this video about when Yeshua said, I'm the light of the world. But one of them, 9:2, was yesterday, was 9:2. It was the 56th year that the wife that's fled in the wilderness to bring forth these first four offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed. It was on Satan's calendar, it marked the completion of the 56th year of her life. And now that ties into him opening the three tiers of the boat on the 56th day after he told his servant Noah to remove the covering from the three tiers of it. It's fascinating. It's all fascinating. But that Isaiah 9 prophecy, part of his Meher Shalal Kushbaz prophecy, says he's going to raise up, behold, a child is given. And Yeshua, again, only fulfilled part of that prophecy, only part of it. And he goes into the events of 9/11, it's of 2001, and how he's tied that into it, the first time that in Isaiah chapter 8, that he right the preceding verses, that he and his king here on earth are reviled on account of the manner he's sending forth this man child and this man child's three siblings. Then it's going to be darkness. Anyways, but he talks, it's crazy. He goes on even then, talking about the great darkness he's getting ready to send on the land because of your rebellion to him and such. But the great light, you've looked upon a great light now for these 1,616 videos, including this one. And whether I can use a script on the computer and talk about verses or not, I mean, it's amazing. I mean, when you read through, like I just mentioned, Isaiah 16:1, it's truly amazing. You just read through every prophecy. It's written upon me, folks. And I used to talk about them more in the videos, and I'd like to do so again, but it's just not the format that he's given me. Instead, he sent me proclaiming all of his wonderful works, which if I was to speak about all of them, there wouldn't be enough books in the entire earth to contain them. It's all written upon the here and the now. Everything that's happening with you guys killing one another and stuff, and this controversy you have with race war and stuff. Anyway, while a real war is brewing with China and Russia, those five nations, can cause their arrows to not miss you before he turns them back so that they can't take credit for it. But it's amazing. When Yeshua said, I am the light of the world, he said it in John. Well, first of all, you shouldn't marvel that I say I'm the light of the world. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 13, he says, you're the salt of the earth. You'll be the salt of the earth, talking to his disciples, not to the multitude. He didn't have a megaphone. He's talking to his disciples. The multitude was there at the mountain, but he's talking about a famous sermon that's called the Sermon on the Mount, whatever. He's talking to his disciples. He said, he didn't have a megaphone, but he says, you're to be the salt of the earth. And then he goes on in verse 5:13, by the way, was the first delivery waypoint for the Emmanuel man-child, Maher Shalal Kushbaz and his twin sister, Rachel, miscarried them, and a series of miscarriages. That was the first, 5:13 of a couple years ago. And the reconception timings are amazing. But 5:14, completion of these are the truths upon the 34 chapters of the 12 stones of the 34 chapters of these are the truths upon the 12 stones of the 46 great whitewashed stones of the boulder design of his house, that his word is written upon, being destroyed too. Most notably in Isaiah chapter 27, where the King James translates it, chalk stones. His altar. What altar is he talking about? Maybe the Isaiah 19 altar that's going to be in the midst of Egypt. Maybe the Ezekiel 43 altar, the boulder design of his house, he calls it. Folks, this is all so simple. But Yeshua said in, so 5:13, he talks about us being the salt of the earth, and 5:14, the light, but 5:13, the first delivery waypoint. Wait till you hear this one. In 8:12, he says, I'm the light of the, John 8:12, he says, I'm the light of the world. And he says, I don't remember everything with it about not walking in the darkness, but 8:12, the day he brought me into the world on the Danites calendar. 8:12 this year will be the 266th day, the delivery waypoint, because a child is born on average 266 days after conception, 280 days based on the onset of a woman's last menstrual cycle, but 47s versus 38 sevens, all significant. But be the 266th day for the Emmanuel man-child, Maher Shalal Kushbaz, and his twin sister Rachel. 8:12 this year. John 8:12, I'm the light of the world. He says it again in John 9:5. Wait a minute. 9:5 this year is the 266th days for the faithful witness, the 266th day for the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zechariah. Who could make this up? Again, back to his Emmanuel man-child prophecy. Lights, great lights come into the world, folks. Isaiah 9:2. Wow, but what does he mention it again? Talks about to walk in the light. When he talks, could it be John 11:9 when he actually brought me into the world on Satan's calendar? 1962, 11:9, John 11:9. Oh yeah, it is. Behold, the light of the world is standing before you, your faces in this video. But why aren't you the light of the world? His word, like I said, the testimony of his word is the light. Behold, I come in the roll of the book that's written upon me. Yeshua was sent in the image of his word. Why aren't you the image of his word? Because then you could say, behold, I'm the light of the world. I'm the salt of the earth. But you're not. You become good for nothing but to be trampled beneath the filthy, uncircumcised feet of the uncircumcised Philistines, because that's what you are. But one another trampling each other's shed blood under your feet, even as you trample his altar beneath your dual feet by stealing from him.